along Bloor Street West from Bathurst. And I'm not quite sure how far along we'll go. I'm hoping to the Bloor Viaduct though. And we are currently just leaving Bathurst subway station. Which means now I can take my mask off. Construction site on the southwest corner that you can see there, that would have been Honest Ed's, a very famous businessman in Toronto whose son went on to bring live theater back to Toronto. So very influential family within the Toronto culture and history now. And Honest Ed's was definitely a landmark. So now going on to Bloor. So this stretch of the Bloor is called the Annex. And lots of various restaurants and little shops. Very popular neighborhood. Here is the Hot Docks Ted Rogers Cinema, once used to be the Bloor Cinema. I definitely went to saw a lot of different movies at this theater over the years. Across the street there you can see Lee's Palace, a local music venue that has seen lots of people do their first Toronto performance. The big name that comes to mind right now was this was the first place Nirvana played in Toronto. And it was established, I believe, in the late 1980s. Thank you.
was looking, you know, yesterday.
I don't think they're there.
Across the street there, Rexall. I used to be the old Brunswick House, a popular bar in the area, especially with the University of Toronto crowd. There's another landmark along here that's gone now. People in a friendly mood today. It's two waves in probably 10 minutes, not even. This church over here, which I can't remember the name of, so I'm trying to see it up here. Trinity St. Paul Center. So it has lots of different organizations who have offices in there. Social justice causes, political causes, not-for-profits, personal support programs. That probably wouldn't have anywhere to house them if they weren't offering it. So, important part of the community. heading north on Spadina. If you went up there, you would eventually hit Forest Hill. Casa Loma is up that way. There's landmarks. And going south on Spadina, well, you see the CN Tower there. Quite boldly, you also would enter into Chinatown. And also down towards there is Kensington Market. So. So we're now leaving the annex and going into the downtown core. Right through this stretch though, very predominant for UFT buildings. Technically still part of the annex, but it just doesn't feel quite the same. On the side streets it does, but along Bloor not so much. Another interesting old church. I'll be honest, I don't know anything about this one, but definitely interesting architecture. So a couple of buildings of interest coming up now. First one is over here, this apartment building. And that was originally built to be Rochdale, and was Rochdale, I believe late 60s into the mid 70s. It was a UFT experimentation in education, which was extremely controversial. Got known as a haven for drugs and basically lifestyle that wasn't very well accepted at the time. Basically was an extension and probably a bit of a blow up of the Yorkville scene at the time. I did understand though that Rush, a Toronto band, recorded its first demo in the basement here. So a little piece of music trivia there. But definitely a controversial place. And definitely lots of information online if you're interested in looking at it. Piece of unknown, not so much spoken of Toronto history. Now next to there is the Bata Shoe Museum. I went there once and surprisingly it was actually interesting. I didn't really think I was going to get anything out of it. I actually quite enjoyed it, so I'd recommend it. When things get back to normal, I know you can also, if you're a Toronto resident, you can get free passes for the Bata Shoe Museum through the Toronto Public Library, amongst other different museums and activities throughout the city. Definitely worth looking at, such as the Royal Ontario Museum, which we'll be coming up to shortly, is also one of them. So another U of T building over there. The Rotman Commerce building. There's an incredibly interesting house here. I don't know how well we'll get to see it. I'll be honest, I don't know anything about this house, but I always marveled at its architecture. Across here is the School of Global Affairs. So it's now called the Monk School of Global Affairs and Public Policy. And here we have the Ontario Institute for Studies in Education, which is also a U of T experiment. I guess it's been successful, which competed apparently against Rochdale at one point. So, right, over 50 years of impact is what they're stating there. And across here is Varsity Stadium. Home of the Varsity Blues, as it says, which is the U of T football team. Other noticeable teams that have played there would be the Toronto Argonauts, Toronto Blizzard. So. Brings us up to Bedford. And if you go up Bedford, is one of the entrances to St. George Subway. The other one was back at that building I showed you that I didn't know. have to come up this street. Cycling lanes here are fairly new. Well, they've been redeveloped anyway along this stretch, which I think is a great addition. I don't cycle anymore. I used to, and definitely cycling lanes were always a great thing to have for the safety of the cyclists and the drivers of automobiles. And I think anything that promotes cycling is a great thing. So, coming up to this big crystal type structure that is the Royal Ontario Museum. This is the addition to it, and a rather controversial one. Some people love it, some people hate it. I'm not a big fan, but I guess beauty is in the eye of the beholder, to give a corny saying to it. Yeah, I was trying to remember the name of it. It is the Michael Lee Chin crystal. Again, the ROM is another place that you can get free passes through the Toronto Public Library. So, if you're on a budget, you can still get in and see things, which is great. Just coming up to Queen's Park and Avenue Road. Avenue Road is to the north. Queen's Park is to the south. Churches in Toronto. It's definitely one of the oldest. So up there is Avenue Road. At the very top you can see Upper Canada College's clock tower. I don't know if you can make that out. And to the south you can see the CN Tower. And dead center is the Ontario Legislature. I don't know if you'll be able to make that out on this picture. And there's the old frontage of the ROM. We're going to switch sides of the street in a moment. And this brings us into officially have left the annex now, and we are into an area quite often known as the Mink Mile because of its high end stores. Here you find Prada, Gucci, all high-end names. Such as Louis Vuitton over there. And next to him will be Tiffany's. Then you have Burberry. Montblanc. Or I could buy a pen, that's probably more than my rent. This is Max Mara. And something you don't usually see here, an empty storefront. Montclair. And Gucci coming soon. I would have thought Gucci was already here. I'm sure it was somewhere. Just changing locations. Cartier there. And a little out of place is Winners Home Sense. Not your high end. More the type of place I can afford to shop at. Not my favorite though. Oh, and here's Prada. Another vacant storefront. Again, very odd for this area. Coach. So I'm not going to bother reading all the names now. You can figure them out. Across the way here, where it says luxury retail for lease, that was University Theater, and that was one of the mainstay theaters. Used to be the big host for Festival of Festivals back in the time, which became the Toronto Movie Festival. If you look at, I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but there's a laneway up there, and that would lead you right into Yorkville. coming up to Bay Street now. That's known as the Financial Street, but not up here. So, to the north of us again would be Yorkville. And if you were to go south, you will see the Financial District down there, way down there though. I don't think you actually get to see it from here, because it does do a twist at Queen. So this is the Manulife Center, and apparently this lineup is for Italy, which is a restaurant I haven't tried. It's quite popular. Now across the street is Holt Renfrew, a high-end department store. With its valet parking, gives you an idea. So the old site of Stollery's here, which is a men's store, well, men's and women's, but seem to cater mainly to men's store, wear, was built in 1911 and came down in 2015. So, long-standing business in Toronto gone. But friendly people today. Here's Yonge Street, Toronto's main street. So we're going south, we'll take you right into the downtown core. And going north, we'll take you into, well, what they call Midtown now. And I always think of this as Uptown. Across the street we have the Hudson Bay Center, but this is kind of upper downtown, I guess you could say. Hudson Bay Center has never been a very attractive building. Very much a concrete slab, really. And never found very well laid out inside, so definitely not one of my favorites.
Right.
That would be the entrance into the Young Bloor subway, as would the Hudson Bay Center. Perkin on Bloor, which I would have known as the Spotted Dick back in the time. So this is Church Street coming up. If you were to go north on it, that would swing around and join up with Yonge Street very shortly. Just not even as far up as the Rosedale subway station, which is the next subway station on the Yonge line. And to the south would be the village. All the way down, you get down right to the waterfront. No, it's a front street anyway. Don't think it goes into the Portlands and down. Well, it once was the waterfront. Over here is the Manulife building. And over here is St. Paul of Bloor Street Church, which I believe is mentioned in Timothy Finley's novel, The Wars. Definitely a good read if you're looking for a book to read. Not sure what the statue is. The center plaque says, "I was a stranger and you welcomed me." Across this bridge to the north here is Mount Pleasant, which will take you up to Midtown, nearly up to York Mills. And to the south, it will bend over and join in to Jarvis, which will take you right into the downtown core. And that's a street I'd like to do a walk on one day and look at the mansions on Jarvis. They're quite impressive. So just coming up to Sherburn now. So if you were to go north along here, you're going back into Rosedale area. Rosedale is one of the richest areas, and then if you go south, you're in the St. James Town, then down further you're into Moss Park, definitely one of the sketchier areas of Toronto, and quite the contrast between the two that basically border each other. Another older church. This is the Church of St. Peter and St. Simon the Apostle. And it is an Anglican church. Neat little street down there. Sorry, just a little bit of a water break there, so I may have bounced all over the place on you. Just coming up to Parliament Street here now. So this is the north end of Parliament Street, and if we were to take it all the way south, well, not all the way, just very shortly down the road is Cabbage Town. But we are going to be continuing along Bloor. Here is St. James Cemetery, one of the older cemeteries in Toronto. It was established in 1844, which by Toronto standards is going back a fair ways. It would have been the city of York, I think, still at that point. And this was fairly north for it back then. Thank you. Now I believe this bridge is going over the Rosedale Valley. Someone knows better, please let me know. Or at least I believe. I do see some cars down there, and there is a road, so I do believe that's the Rosedale Valley. I don't know if you guys can see those cars there. A lot of tree coverage. But I'll join up with Bayview in just a little bit. And over here is Castle Frank subway station. Now, Castle Frank apparently is named after the son of John Simcoe, who is Governor General of Upper Canada, and his son's name was Francis, and he built a lodge up here somewhere. I overlooked the valley, and it got known as Castle Frank as a kind of a joke. And here's Castle Frank Crescent, a very upscale address to have. And then we come up to Castle Frank Road. And all these cars are turning off, which is them coming off the Don Valley Parkway. See people out cycling. This is the entrance to the Rosedale School of the Arts, I believe. Growing up, I knew it as Castle Frank High School. And I don't think it was quite the same prestige to go there as it is now. And another channel, Johnny Strides, did a walk down through there, and there's a staircase that'll take you right down into the valley. So, if you want to check that out, check out his channel. Now we're coming up to the Bloor Viaduct. This was a bridge that was built, I believe it was in the 1920s. It's also known as the Prince of Wales Bridge to some extent, as it was ceremoniously opened by the Prince of Wales at the time. And it definitely was important in the sense that it connected the east end to the center of the city. So the valley definitely separated, especially at this end of the city. As you go over, you'll see that the valley is quite deep. Now you also see the distress center line, because this was at one point, I don't know if it still is, but it was the most popular part in Toronto, most popular bridge anyway, to jump off of to commit suicide. And I did know one person who actually did that in their teen years. It's the Prince Edward Viaduct. And Prince Edward at the time was the Prince of Wales. Later to become King Edward, and later to have to step down because he wanted to marry the love of his life. And I can't remember her first name right off, but Simpson was her last name. An American divorcee, and that just wasn't going to work. So you'll see these barriers up here with the wires and such. They've been constructed to try to make it so you can't get up onto the bridge to jump off. That's why they have the distress numbers at the end. They used to have payphones at the end also, so you'd be able to make the call. Payphones are something you see less and less of. So once we get into the center of the valley, I'll definitely just turn you over for you to see the view, which is quite stunning. Just heard the subway going underneath, which is one piece that I forgot. And the smart thing was, in the 1920s when they built this, there was no subway, but they designed this bridge so it could have a subway. It's underneath it. They were thinking ahead, and that saved a lot of money. Down there, that's Bayview Avenue, and just up at the lights there, if you can see them, that would be Rosedale Valley Road. So that's where that would come out, just a little ways down. Thank you. large glass building down there. I forget what it's called now, but it used to be Riverdale Hospital. It's still a hospital. I don't know if you can see the buildings right next to it, the low-lying ones, older. That's the Don Jail. Now, just below us is the Don River. You really can't see it for the tree cover here, though. See the CN Tower and the top of the BMO there. Oh, there's the river down there. Don't know how well you can make that out. Right beneath us, that's the Don River. Hence the name of the Don Valley. And the expressway here is the Don Valley Expressway, which then at the 401 highway turns into Highway 404. And some have said that the Don Valley is the most beautiful expressway because it goes right through a wooded valley. Trails, walking trails through the Don Valley, and you can take that right up to Edwards Gardens if you wanted to, which is through Wilkett Creek, which is another video I did earlier in the summer. Adult Learning Center. I believe originally that was called Lakeside. Thank you. And with that, we crossed the Bloor Viaduct. This building here, if I remember right, originally was a public washroom. And is now converted to a daycare. It was originally, I remember that as a public washroom years and years back. Oh, nice to see lights here. And these lights didn't used to be here, and this used to be always fun. This is the entrance, the ramp onto the Don Valley Parkway. I used to see people take chances along here. A lot of people out cycling, which is great to see. This comes to Broadview, which was the end of my night walk last night. So I think it's a good place to end it. My night walk is uploading at the moment. I just checked and it hasn't yet. But that should be up there in the next few hours. And I'll be uploading this one when I get home, hopefully. So with that, I'll sign off. Have a good day, everyone.